हेलो, आई डॉक्टर विनीता, एमपीटी ऑर्थो, एंड टुडेज आवर टॉपिक इज टेंस थेरेपी एंड फिजियोथेरेपी जुनून. व्हाट इज़ द टेंस स्टैंड फॉर? टेंस स्टैंड फॉर द ट्रांसक्यूटेनियस इलेक्ट्रिकल नर्व स्टिमुलेशन. ओके, एंड what is the tense? Tense is a very non-invasive analgesic technique that is used to relieve nociceptive neuropathic and musculoskeletal pain. There is so many studies on the tense therapy used for the patients, okay, for pain relieving. Transcutaneous electrical nerve stimulation is a inexpensive, okay, and self-administrative technique with no known potential for overdose. TENS as a stand-alone treatment for mild to moderate pain and as an adjunct to the pharmacotherapy for moderate to severe pain. Pain relief is maximal when strong, non-painful tense paresthesia are experienced beneath the electrodes. So patient may need to administer tense throughout the day. Tense selectively activate low threshold peripheral afferent A-beta fibers, which inhibit ongoing nociceptive transmissions in the central nervous system. In BPT, almost in all the colleges, in BPT, आप लोग सिर्फ definitions, precautions, contraindications और general physiology पढ़ते हो. Okay, today we study that how evidence-based approaches or evidence-based studies say about TENS therapy. Okay, how to use the TENS therapy, okay, and what are the mechanism behind this, all you study in this video. Okay, so we start our new topic. The transcutaneous electrical nerve stimulation is a non-invasive, inexpensive, self-administered technique to relieve pain. देखो, टेंस तो एक पेशेंट को आप बताओगे कि आपको ऐसे ऐसे इलेक्ट्रो लगाने हैं, ये करना है, वो पेशेंट भी लगाएगा. बट यू आर ए फिजियोथेरेपिस्ट, सो यू नो द डिफरेंस. ओके, और यू हैव सो मच नॉलेज. So the exact knowledge or exact where you place the electrode, at what intensity and what is the frequency, okay, this differentiate you from the normal. Okay, and I can say ki अच्छे physiotherapist और एक normal physiotherapist में भी आपको एक difference create करेगा आपके बीच में. Okay, there are few side effects and no potential for overdose, so patient can titrate the treatment as required. लेकिन इसमें भी एक आप देख रहे हैं, patient कभी कितने भी time तक लगा सकता है, but it's not the true statement. Why this is not true? Why it's false? Because if patient is using the tense whole day or through repetitive manner, what will happen? A normal physiotherapist or physio, agar wo pura din tense laga raha hai, what will happen? The muscles will fatigue, okay, easily, and pain provoke. So next, tense technique include, what are the tense technique? One is the conventional tense, acupuncture like tense, and the intense tense. In general, the conventional tense is used in the first instance. what we study today, principle of nerve fiber activation, principle under pinning type of tense technique, conventional tense, acupuncture-like tense, intense tense. What are the physiological intentions behind the conventional tense? Selective activation of large diameter, non-noxious afferent to elicit the segmental analgesia. Acupuncture-like tense, activation of small diameters, afferent to elicit the extra-segmental analgesia. And what are the intense tense? The activation of the small diameter, afferent to elicit the peripheral nerve blockade and extra-segmental analgesia. Clinical techniques behind this: low intensity. The conventional tense is low intensity, high frequency. Tense is site of pain to produce strong but comfortable tense paresthesia. Administer whenever in pain. Then we study the acupuncture-like tense. High intensity, low frequency, tense over muscle, acupuncture points or trigger point to produce strong but comfortable muscle contraction. Administer for 15 to 30 minutes at time. And the intense tense, high intensity, high frequency, tense over nerve arising from painful side to produce maximum tolerable or painful tense paresthesia. Administer for a few minutes at a time. If the pulse amplitude of tense is increased further, nociceptive nerve fibers are activated. Okay, and the user experiences a painful tingling under the electrodes. Pulse duration between 50 and 500 ms enable the user titrate pulse amplitude with greater precision. This study is done by the Hosens in 1978. The pulse current with small amplitude and duration between 50 to 500 ms would be best to activate the large diameter fibers. Without activating small diameter nociceptive fibers. Okay, you see that 5 to 1500 ms, which is best activate the large diameter fibers, A beta fibers, and note the A delta and C fibers. If the pulse amplitude of tense is increased further, nociceptive nerve fibers are activated and the user experiences a painful tingling under the electrodes. The pulse duration above 500 ms will lead to the activation of small diameter fibers. At lower pulse amplitudes, the number of nerve impulses generated by tense will increase according to the frequency of the pulse current. Although this is limited by absolute and relative refractory period for the axon, theoretically delivering tense at high pulse frequencies should be optimum. Strength duration curve. Okay, you see the stimulus amplitude, and the here you see small diameter afferent, motor afferent, and large diameter. Here you see that 50 to 500, okay, and you see the motor large air. Here you see the difference between the large diameter afferent fibers, motor afferent fibers, and small afferent fibers. Okay, strength duration curve for fiber activation: as pulse duration increases, less current amplitude is needed to excite an axon to generate an action potential. Small pulse duration are unable to excite nerve axon even at high current amplitude. Large diameter axon require lower current amplitude than small diameter fibers. Thus, passing pulsed current across the surface of the skin excite the large diameter non-noxious sensory nerve first, like paresthesia type, followed by motor efferent muscle contraction and small diameter noxious efferent, which is for pain. Alteration of pulse duration is one means to help in the selective recruitment of different type of nerve fibers. For example, like in intense tense, should use the long pulse duration, 50 above than 50, as they activate small diameter afferent more readily. And during conventional tests, the pulse duration is above 100-200 ms between are used, as there is a large separation difference, okay, in the amplitude needed to recruit different type of fibers. This enables greater precision when using the intensity, okay, amplitudes dial, so that a strong but comfortable paresthesia can be achieved without muscle contraction or without pain. So you see the difference between the long pulse duration and they activate the small diameter afferent fibers, okay, or the tense pulse duration like 100-200, there's a lot of difference, and they activate and recruit the different type of fibers, okay, and this is very comfortable for induce the paresthesia, okay, and we achieve the paresthesia phase and without the more muscle contraction or pain. Described in the literature are conventional tens, acupuncture-like tens, and intense tens. Okay. This study is in 2006. These tense techniques suggest the electrical characteristics of the currents that are necessary to activate different type of nerve fibers. Although the emphasis on electrical characteristics has resulted in the use of inflexible prescriptive protocols in clinical practice and research. What are the purpose of the conventional tens is to selectively activate large diameter non-noxious afferents, A beta, to reduce nociceptor cell activity and sensitization at a segmental level in the central nervous system. Pain relief with conventional tens is rapid in onset and offset and is maximal when the patient experiences a strong but non-painful paresthesia beneath the electrodes. Therefore, patient may need to administer tens throughout the day. Okay, in this content, we use that term that patient can use the tens throughout the day. Why? Because the conventional tens is very strong, okay, and non-painful, create a non-painful paresthesia beneath the electrodes. Okay, how this is work? Like in every modality, you see that one is black, one is red. Okay, according to manufacturer, there is a different anode and different cathode. But here we just imagine that black is anode and red one is cathode. Okay, the anode one is positive and cathode one is negative. Okay, and in your body, you see that NaCl. Okay. Na is positive and Cl is negative. Okay, there is movement when we apply the tense therapy or electrodes. There is movement of the ions. Okay, there is formation of the depolarization and hyperpolarization. How depolarization and hyperpolarization? When anode and cathode is moving, if there is lots of NaCl ions, okay, there is ionic configuration is changes, and that will lead to the depolarization and hyperpolarization, and potentially blocked by the pain is blocked by the hyperpolarization, and The nerve impulses or the pain pathway is blocked after that, okay? And so that patient not feel pain. But here you see when there is a conventional tense, there is the hyperpolarization is normal, so that there is no pain further feel by the patient. But in case of acupuncture like tense, there is, if hyperpolarization is occur, there is a tingling sensation patient will feel and patient feel pain. So that sometime you have patient coming or aapne usko tense laga diya, patient aapko complain kar raha hai ki tense lagane ke baad mujhe pehle pain tha, but tense lagane ke baad मुझे पेन ज़्यादा हो गया. क्यों ज़्यादा हो गया? आप उसकी कंडीशन देखो. बिकॉज कई बार ऐसा चांस भी हो सकता है स्वेलिंग है या फिर वहाँ पे जो है लिक्विड एक्यूमुलेशन है और डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सिचुएशन. आपको कन्वेंशनल टेंस अप्लाई करना था लेकिन आपने वहाँ पे जो है आप एक्यूपंक्चर लाइक टेंस अप्लाई कर रहे हो, ठीक है. एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट द इलेक्ट्रोड प्लेसमेंट, ओके. Postulated mechanism. What is the postulated mechanism? The postulated mechanism is the low intensity, non noxious tense paresthesia. Okay, for like conventional tense, relieve pain by the segmental mechanism. Higher intensity tense increase the likelihood of activity. Extra segmental descending pain, inhibitory pathways. And activate the diffuse non-noxious inhibitory control via counter-irritant effects. Okay, tense will also cause peripheral blockade of afferent impulses that have been arisen from the peripheral structures. So that the segmental mechanism, first postulated mechanism is on, like. You see here, when you place the tens or electrodes, there is formation of the anode and the cathode, okay, positive and negative fibers, okay, mechanoreceptors. Here this is the patient's skin, for example. Here you place the electrodes, low threshold efferent activated by the tens, okay, and they goes and they do what, the paresthesia, tense paresthesia. And the nociceptives, high threshold afferent activities start, release the inhibitory neurotransmitters here, and inhibiting of the activity in central nociceptive transmission cell, and what it lead to the pain reduce. This is your conventional tense procedure, how conventional tense is working, okay. And here you see the peripheral blockade of the afferent fibers, peripheral blockade. Next is the segmental mechanism. Evidence from the animal studies show that tense reduce ongoing nociceptive cells activity and sanitization in the central nervous system when applied to somatic receptive fields. Tense induce a delta activity, cause long term depressions of central nociceptive cell activity for up to 2 hours. Okay, so see that a delta fibers, when you apply the tense, there is formation of anode and cathode. Here is your skin, okay. The tense paresthesia, we just learn about this in previous slides. Here you see the touch afferent a beta fibers and blockage and the peripheral blockage, okay. Nociceptive afferent fibers, it will go from here and it affect the CNS system and blockade of the incoming nociceptive input within the spinal cord, and it is for this activity, central nociceptive cell activity, for 2 hours. It depresses the this activity for 2 hours. In case of extra segmental mechanism, what will happen? The tens induce activity in small diameter afferents, a delta, lead to activation of the midbrain, okay, periquitally and gray and rostral ventromedial medulla. Descending inhibitory pathways and inhibition of the descending pain facilitatory pathways, larger effect have been observed when muscle rather than skin afferent are used. Here you see that the extrasegmental mechanism, it affects the midbrain, okay, and the descending inhibitory pathway. Next, we here you see that when you apply the tens, low threshold afferent A beta fibers, okay, they goes through the brain, okay, and here is the tens paresthesia is happen, and pain almost reduced, okay, and if it is affect the cord, spinal cord, the pain gate pathway is nociceptive activators, and high threshold afferent A delta fibers were activate, and there is pain gate mechanism is starts, and pain gate closed, and here you see that patient feels no pain, okay. Peripheral mechanism. What is the peripheral mechanism? The peripheral mechanism is defined as the tens generate nerve impulses that will collide and extinguish noxiously induce orthodromatic impulses arising from peripheral structures. Okay, peripheral blockades of nociceptive impulses is more likely when tens activate A delta fibers. Okay, it is intense tens. In example, tens induce activity in large diameter afferent fibers, like example in the conventional tens will block afferent activity in large diameter fibers that may be contributing to pain. What are the features of the tens? Here we see the features of the tens. Features of the tens like weight, okay, dimensions, cost, and the pulse waveform which is fixed, monophagic, biphagic, okay, or biphagic in asymmetry, okay, pulse amplitude, okay, and the pulse duration, pulse frequency, pulse pattern, channels, 1 channel, 2 channel, 3 channel, 4 channel, what are the batteries and the additional factors, okay. Clinical experience suggests that tens may be beneficial as an adjunct to the pharmacotherapy for acute pain. Although systemic review are conflicting, clinical experience and systemic reviews suggest that tens is beneficial for chronic pain also. In many there is many studies जो ये बोल रही हैं कि भाई जो एक फार्मा की तरह हम यूज़ करते थे एक्यूट पेन के अंदर, बट सिस्टमिक रिव्यू और जो फिजियोथेरेपिस्ट बार बार एडवांस रिसर्च जो कर रहे हैं, दे से दैट द टेंस इज़ बेनिफिशियल फॉर क्रोनिक पेन ऑल्सो. ओके, दैट्स गुड फॉर द फिजियोथेरेपिस्ट. That tens is good for chronic pain also. And next is the here this evidence based practice and nerve stimulation from author's name. In this lecture we cover all the topics like what are the principle, what are the different mechanism, and segmental, non-segmental, all we cover in this. Next, in next lecture or in next video, we cover the what are the different type of uses or doses, okay, how to place the electrodes, okay. All we cover in the next video. And thank you so much. Please like, share, and subscribe my video. Thank you.